Yeah, it got, you know, it got shut down. So yeah. Yes. So, look at this train here. The favorable outcomes is what? One. So, what is the favorable outcome? The favorable outcome which I am getting that is satisfying to my given condition. What is the given condition here? What is the given condition here?
Sir, two heads.
No, given condition is what? Both heads we have to get. Both heads, which is what? This is my favorable outcome. Unfavorable outcome is nothing but what now? The total number of outcomes. What is the total number of outcomes? Yes. How much? What is the total number of 4 minus?
F4.
4 minus what? Favorable outcome 1, which is nothing but 3. 3 are unfavorable outcomes. So look at this here. 1, 2, 3. These 3 are unfavorable outcome, isn't it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So
Yes.
favorable outcome is nothing but what? The outcome which I'm getting, that should satisfy with what? That should satisfy with what? That should
The
satisfy with
condition.
condition. Yeah. I got one favorable outcome. That, you know, that. Except this one, whatever the remaining thing you have, that is what unfavorable outcome. Whatever the thing you have, except that, look at it here. In the sample space, I had 4 possible outcomes. These are possible outcomes, isn't it? The 1, 2, 3, 4. These are possible outcomes. Yes or no? Guys, here possible outcomes are
Yes.
different than favorable outcomes. Try to understand. Favorable outcome is nothing but the outcome which I am going to get, the outcome which I get, that should satisfy the given condition. Look at this, both heads. So I'm getting both heads what? Only one favorable outcome. So yeah. All right. Yes. The unfavorable outcome is nothing but what? Total number of possible outcomes minus this one. So which means D gives me 3. Shrein, I hope I cleared your doubt. Shrein, I cleared your doubt, I hope. Yes.
இருந்து
Yes. Yes, got it. Yes. So, Shreyan, I hope I cleared your doubt. Shreyan, Shreyan, are you Shreyan, are you here? Yes, so this is what an example. Okay, so I'll give one more question. You should tell me what are the favorable outcomes and what are the not favorable outcomes. Okay, the question is tossing three coins. What are the favorable possible outcomes? Tell me first. Possible outcomes I told yesterday, which I denote with S, which means triple HST. So you write like this: HT. What are the possible outcomes now? HT. So TH, 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 HH, these are the possible outcomes, isn't it? So now if I ask you the question, that the question is probability of getting all tail
1/8.
So what is the what is favorable outcome now? Favorable outcome is one here.
Favorable outcome.
What is unfavorable outcome here?
7/8.
A total number of outcomes minus favorable outcome. What is that? 1, which is 7. So 7 is what? Unfavorable outcome. I hope I cleared it out.
Yeah, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, chalo. So this is what basically favorable and unfavorable outcome is all about. All right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Chalo. Next. So the whichever I wrote here, that is very, very important. This note is very, very important here. Okay, please stay, just try to understand it. Next. Next. This is also very, very important. Hope it is clear with everyone.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Yes.
The probability of favorable and unfavorable events happening depends upon the number of trials performed. All right. Okay. So however, the sum of both these probabilities is always equal to 1. So what is the meaning of this? Let us try to understand the same. Very, 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 very important. Very, very important. Look at this. The probability of favorable and unfavorable events. Favorable is nothing but what? Just now I told you what is favorable outcome. Unfavorable outcome is nothing but what? Remaining. Total S minus N. Okay. So yes, unfavorable outcome or unfavorable events happening depends on the number of trials performed. Number of trial. What do you mean by trial? For suppose you're tossing a coin. Tossing a coin, which means one trial. All right, tossing three coins, one trial. Number of trials performed. That is completely depends on what? The favorable outcomes and unfavorable outcomes. Getting favorable and unfavorable outcomes completely depends on what? Number of trials you perform on that particular experiment. However, the sum of both, these probabilities always equal to one. Sir, what is this? What is this always equal to one? Look at this here. Very, very important. Let us talk about example. So, first suppose tossing two coin. So, tossing a coin. Any example you take. Okay, tossing a coin. So, now when you're tossing, what is the possible outcomes here? H comma T. Isn't it? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, now,
yes, sir.
First suppose if I give a question, that probability of getting head is what? 1/2. Yes or no? Yes or
yes,
no?
Sir.
Huh. So what is one year? One is what year? Favorable outcome. Favorable outcome. Now what is, now you write then what is unfavorable outcome? What is unfavorable outcome? Number of unfavorable outcomes is what? Total number of outcomes. Look at this sample. How many? 1, 2. So 2 minus favorable outcome. What is that? 1. Which is nothing but what? 1. All right. So this is my unfavorable outcome. Okay. Favorable outcomes, how much? Therefore, sum of favorable outcomes. Now, favorable outcome plus unfavorable outcome. I mean, probability of favorable outcome plus probability of unfavorable outcome is equal to 1. How 1? Look at this here. What is the probability of favorable outcome here? 1. What is the probability of favorable outcome? 1 by 2, isn't it? 1 out of 2. Yes or no?
Yes, plus sir.
Probability of unfavorable outcome is what? 1.
1 by 2, sir.
Half plus half. How much? 1. So 1 is equal to 1 or not? Look at this. 1 is equal to 1 or not?
Yes, sir.
Which means what you understood from this? So whenever you get probability of favorable and outcome, favorable and unfavorable outcomes, completely depends on the number of trials you perform. If you are performing one time, so depends on that. According to that, you have to you will get favorable and unfavorable outcomes. If you are performing twice, thrice like that, depends on that you will be getting favorable and unfavorable outcome. And look at this. However, the sum of these both probabilities, both means what here? Which both? Favorable and unfavorable, both, isn't it? Probability of favorable outcome plus probability of unfavorable outcomes is always going to be equal to 1. Look at this. Whatever the example you take, let me take. Guys, how many of you understood this example? So favorable outcomes is what? Here, as per the question, I am asking you the probability of head is what? What is the favorable outcome here? 1. Okay, then unfavorable outcomes, how much? 2 minus 1. Yes or no?
Yes.
Simple.
Sir.
Let me tell you a common sense here. So out of between these two, favorable outcome is 1. Then unfavorable outcome is what? Remaining 1, isn't it? This is my favorable outcome. Now, what is the remaining? How many remaining things you have? Only one outcome I remain with. Only one outcome I just left with. That is my unfavorable outcome. Common sense. Okay. Yes or no? So
yes,
probability of favorable outcome is 1 by 2 I got. Probability of unfavorable outcome is also 1 by 2. So half plus half 1. So 1 is equal to 1 only. No, that's what I was saying, right? Sum of probability of favorable outcome and unfavorable outcome is equal to always 1. So that is what the condition of the probability lesson. Okay. Shall I give one more example so that you have to just verify whether you are getting a sum of probability of favorable outcome and unfavorable outcome equal to 1 or not? You just tell me. Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Tell me. You have an experiment called rolling.
The dice?
Yeah. Best example, rolling dice, tossing coin. What, wherever you go, these two exams are best examples to understand any concept. Okay, rolling a die. Okay, so the question is, this is an experiment. Let me write experiment. I'm just denoting with E here. Okay, E is equal to this much. Okay, what is the sample space?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Possible outcomes. Possible outcomes are what? When you roll a die, you might get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are my possible outcomes. All right. Now the question is, probability of getting a prime number. Prime number. What is that?
1 by 2.
2 by 5. 2 by 6.
Prime number.
2 by 6. 3
prime numbers I have here.
So 1 by 2, sir.
So 3 prime numbers. 1, 2, 3. 2 is a prime number. 3 is a prime number. Even 5 also a prime number, isn't it? So total number of favorable outcomes, how much now? 3. Out of how many? Out of 6.
Six.
Which means which means three favorable outcomes. Yes or no? So then unfavorable outcomes, how much?
So that
was
also
3/6. That is also 3. Look at the unfavorable. No. I'm talking about unfavorable outcome, not yes, probability of unfavorable outcome. Try to understand my question here.
Number of
unfavorable outcomes, how much?
So 3.
Number of unfavorable outcomes is equal to 3. How 3? Total number of possible outcomes minus positive. This favorable outcomes, which gives you what? 3 only. All right. Now, probability of unfavorable outcome. What is the probability of unfavorable outcome? Unfavorable outcome is what? 3.
1/2, sir.
6.
1/2.
1 minus 1/2.
Look at it, sir. This is 1/2 I got. What is the probability of this? This is also 1/2, right? So now sum of probability of favorable outcome plus sum of probability of favorable outcome plus sum of probability of unfavorable outcome. Dono ko add karne se mujhe kya milega? Sum of probability of favorable outcome and unfavorable outcome gives me 1 here. Look at this. Every time you get the same thing. Look at it. Let me give one more question here. Same experiment. Experiment is same. I'm changing the question. Probability of getting an even number. Tell me. Or else let me tell you probability of getting a unity. Probability of getting a unity. Tell me. Probability of getting a unity is what? Unity is nothing but what? Very good question.
So what is unity?
Unity is nothing but unity is nothing but always one. You have to take one.
Okay, sir. So then it is 1/6, right?
Yeah, 1/6. Very simple.
Sir, out of
one, I don't understand why you did half plus half.
That is what I have been telling Sujay. Are you not listening the class?
Sir, I'm listening, but I still don't understand.
What you didn't understand, tell me here.
So why are you adding?
See, the condition was, That is a condition. When you add these two, you must get one. That is a condition of probability that mathematician found. Okay. As per that conditions, what is that? However, the sum of these probabilities, sum of these both probability, what both denotes here? Sum of favorable and
unfavorable.
If you add both, so you must get always one. You must always get one. That is a condition. That is, look at it, sum. Okay, that is the reason I'm adding and showing you how we are getting one. So now probability of getting a unity is what? Unity is nothing but one.
Okay, you're just, this is just for checking.
Yeah, we are just, you know, checking whether we are getting one or not. Whatever the example you take, not only this, whatever the example you take in the world. So that will be always sum of probability of favorable and unfavorable outcome, always one. Listen to me carefully, each and every word whichever I'm telling here, listen to me carefully, very, very carefully. Even you just divert your mind for a second, you will not understand next step. Please try to understand, every one of you. Yes, tell me, what is the answer of this? What is the probability of favorable outcome?
1/6.
Favorable outcome.
That's one.
Favorable outcome. Probability I'm asking. So number of favorable outcome is 1. Unity is nothing but what? Unity is nothing but one.
Unity means one.
Unity means one. Try to remember that. So one out of. How many times you get one?
Six.
How many times you get one? Only one time. So one time out of how many times? Six times.
Six. Out of six.
So probability of unfavorable outcome is what?
5/6.
So add this to now. 1/6 plus 5/6. So 6/6, which always one. Look at this. Whatever the example you take, beta. Okay? All right. Aaya samajh?
Yes, sir.
No. Look at it. Add these two. 1/6 plus 5/6, which gives you 6/6, which always one. Look at this. Clear? Any doubts?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt, sir.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Kaji.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, Kaji, please.
Sir, how 5 came?
How 5 came? I think you are not listening the class. Look at this here. Unit is nothing but what? One. You have your sample space is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Unit is nothing but what? One. हमको एक नंबर वन कितना टाइम मिलेगा आई मीन हाउ मेनी टाइम्स यू गेट वन सिक्स टाइम्स बेटा व्हेन यू एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हेन यू डू दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हेन यू रोल ए डाई आपको डाई रोल करने से मुझे देखो डाई कैसा होता है ऐसा होता है ना डाई यू सम हाउ इट विल बी राइट यू 1, 2, 3, 6 साइड्स यू विल बी हैविंग राइट सो सिक्स नंबर्स इट विल बी रिटन ऑन दैट सिक्स नंबर्स विल बी रिटन ओवर दैट राइट सो व्हेन यू रोल ए डाई देयर इज अ चांस You might get one first time, you might get second time, you might get five, third time you might get three, fourth time you might get five, I mean six, then two, any day, like in anything you can get. There is a chance of getting any number on any trial, isn't it? So, yes. Now, probability of getting unity, unity is nothing but what? Unity is nothing but number one, 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 one. Unity means one, okay? Unity means one, digit one, okay? So, how many times there is a chance of getting one here? How many times?
One time,
देखो, only one time, I have read, only one time. Out of how many times?
Six times.
Out of total six times. All right. Out of six times, I might get, look at this. One time is my, so one is what? Number of favorable outcomes is what? Number of favorable outcomes is one. Out of six. So, unfavorable outcome is five.
Understood.
Yeah, that is how you went. So how you got five in here? Five here. Five means total number of how many outcomes here? Total how many? कितना है total? Six. उसमें से किसको घटाना है? Favorable outcome को. One. तो मुझे five मिलेगा. Out of how many? Six.
Six.
That is how probability I write. All right. Hope it is clear. ध्यान से सुनने से आपको कुछ भी like you know कुछ भी doubt नहीं रहेगा. Very very simple common sense लगाने वाला concept है. ठीक है. All right. Yes or no people? Are you getting any noise from my side? दिस इज वॉट इंट्रोडक्शन इज ऑल अबाउट ऑफ योर थिंग एक्चुअली नाउ विल डू वन थिंग We'll solve the questions now. This is what introduction is all about. Your class 9 mein itne se, you should not, you need not to learn more than this actually. Theek hai?
Yeah, are you giving quiz?
Not quiz. I'm giving the questions now. Tomorrow we'll have quiz. No problem. Look at this here. A coin. Everyone, look at this. A coin. Listen to me carefully. A coin is tossed 1,000 times. A coin is tossed 1,000 times with the The following sequence. देखो, what is the sequence here? Head 455. Then tail is what? Tail is of 545. Then he is asking that compute the probability. Compute the probability of each event. Okay, what is the question here? A coin is tossed 1,000 times. A coin is tossed 1,000 times. Okay, so with the following sequence, look at this.
Sir, for head, it's 91 by 200.
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. Head is 455. Tail is 545. Okay, so compute the probability of each event. Look at this now. So let us try to understand this. So thousand time, I'm just tossing a coin, which means number of trials how much?
Thousand
trials total.
Number of trials is equal to much.
Sir, for tail it's 109 by 200.
Wait. If I ask, then only please you should respond. Please let me finish. When I'm just explaining something, don't interrupt, please. Others will get disturbed. If I ask, then you tell me, please. Hope you understand. If you talk in between, definitely you know it will interrupt to someone and you know they will get disturbed. Please. Number of trials is 1,000.
Okay, sir.
So Look at this here. So we have to compute the probability of each event. We have to find the probability of a head event and tail event. All right. So number of favorable outcomes is how much?
So for heads it is 455.
455. Number of how many times? Number of heads you will get 455 times. I mean tail, tail you will get 545. So number of favorable outcomes how much?
455,000. Which?
Yeah. So probability of favorable outcome. Favorable outcome. He given that outcome. So two favorable outcomes how much? Head. So I'm solving the first one, or else you write like this, or else let us give that for event head, let us consider H. Okay, for I'm giving a name. Okay, for event
tail
I'm giving name called T. Okay, now look at this here. Now we'll write probability of favorable outcomes for event H. Okay, for H you write H, outcome for H denotes what? Heads. Okay.
Heads.
So favorable how much? 455. Out of how many events? How many trials?
1,000.
Total number of 1,000. Okay. So now probability of
unfavorable.
Are you able to understand my handwriting? I'm writing somewhat fast. So I'm 500.
1,000 minus 455, right?
Yes. 1,000 minus 455 gives you what?
Unfavorable.
545. He has given. Look at this.
Yeah, 545. Yeah.
He has given. Out of how much? 1,000. Okay.
1,000.
Okay. So this is what your answer. Look at this. If you want to write in decimal, what can you write is 0.455. 0.545, like 545. This is what your probability of this one. Probability. This is what he is asking for. Look at this. Compute the probability of each event. I just computed probability of favorable outcome for H. Okay. Look at, let me write, probability of favorable outcomes for T. So probability of favorable outcomes for T. So what is this? This and this. This answer. All right.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you want to check, these two are different questions here. Okay. These two are different questions. Try to understand. This is a different question. This is a different question here. So for this question, this first question is a second question. Okay. For first two question, if you want to check whether you are getting a sum of probability of favorable outcome and unfavorable outcome as one or not, how do you check?
By adding.
So this is my favorable outcome for the first question. I'm talking about the first question here. Okay. Unfavorable outcome, how much? 1,000 minus 455.
545.
So by 1,000. So 445 plus 455 plus 545 was 1,000.
1,000 by 1,000.
Which gives you one. Same thing here. What is the favorable outcome here for the second question? For the second question, what is the favorable outcome?
545.
Out of how much? 1,000. Unfavorable outcome also, what is the probability of unfavorable outcome for the second one?
455.
Very simple. So look at it, add the both things.
1,000. 1,000.
1,000. 1,000,
sir.
Hence verified. All right. Yes or no? So some of the probabilities of favorable outcomes and unfavorable outcomes of any event should be always what? 1. So that is not required, but I verified you for your understanding purpose. This is what your answer. You should not write more than this actually. This is what your final answer. Hope it is clear with everyone.
Yes, sir. Sir, really, it will be simple like this, sir.
Yeah, entire chapter will be like this only. Believe me, it will be entire chapter like this only. So for your standard, it will be like this. If you go, you're for the 10th, it will be somewhat deeper. 11th, somewhat deeper. 12th, somewhat deeper, like that. But I'm sure it will be very easy. Okay.
Yes.
Need not worry. This is how you need to start this is how we need to start with. Okay. Next, let me give the question.
So I just wanted to ask, sir, did you complete statistics?
Hello?
Sir, did you complete statistics?
Yes. So we have left with only construction, isn't it, children?
Yes, sir. Actually, it's statistics is term one syllabus, sir. Hmm. We are going with term two.
Yeah, we are going to term two. Term two, we are going to finish with one more topic. So after that, fully revision test like that.
So in this revision test, you will be repeating again term one syllabus also, sir.
Full term one and term two, full. Like, you know, term two, we'll give a more priority to term two. Then after yes. that, if you get time, then we'll go for term two. Term one, already we have written more exams. More.
Yes, sir.
Okay, next question. Two coins are tossed simultaneously. Are you able to understand my handwriting? I'm writing somewhat fast. 500 yes. times. People.
Yes, sir, it's understandable.
With the following sequence. Okay. With the following, or not instead of sequence, let me write frequencies. Following frequencies. Frequencies of different outcomes. Different outcomes. All right. So he has given us, you know, frequencies as two heads, 95 times. And one tail, 290 times. No head, 115 times. All right. Now the question is, find the probability of occurrence of each of these events. Look at this. I told you in the starting of the class itself, I told you for understanding the question itself, it takes 2 minutes of time, but writing the answer is 1 minute of time. Just look at this. Two coins are tossed simultaneously 500 times with the following frequencies of different outcomes. Two heads, 95 times. One tail, these many times. No head, 115 times. Then find the probability of. P of means probability of. All right, in short, we read that. Probability of occurrence of each of these events. Total number
so
of...
So, 95 by 100 for the first one.
95.
Yeah, very simple. 95. Yeah, what is it? Look at this. For the first one, let me read the answer. Very simple. Look at the probability of two heads. What is that? 95 times. Out of how many times? How many trials?
500 times.
So that is what your probability. If you want to convert in decimal, you can convert like that itself. Now probability of one tail.
Sir, 290 by 500.
The probability of which no head. Which is nothing but what? 115
by 500.
This is what your answer. This is yes, what your answer. Sir. Very simple, isn't it? How simple? This is a solution actually. Look at this. I told you that understanding the question itself takes more time rather than, you know, understanding the question itself take more time than, you know, solving the answer. Solving the answer is very simple, actually. They go 95 by 500, 290 by 500, 115 by 500. This is what your answer. Isn't it? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Say time to unmute, sir. I got confused with the shortcut.
Didn't get you?
Nothing, sir. I'm saying that it's taking time to unmute, sir. I forgot the shortcut.
It's taking time to?
Unmute the mic, sir.
For you?
Yes, sir. It's taking a bit time. For me.
Oh, then check your settings, I think. Okay. Any doubts here?
No doubts, sir.
Okay. So, children, tomorrow we'll be having quiz. Based upon probability, let's see, at the end of the class we'll have a quiz, not starting of the class, so we'll cover a few more questions so that at the end of the class you will be able to understand all the stuff, then we can have a quiz on that. Okay, all right.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, so then let's have a wind up the session now. So and we'll meet in the next session, and while coming to the session, please listen to me, every one of you revise the notes and come back. All right.
Yes, sir.
And come back.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
There, sir. Sir, yes. One thing I want to say, sir, for my schedule, sir, scattered in our school means January 3rd, our exams will start. They will start, they will revise us, sir, in the schedules. So, I will not have a time to do the worksheet, sir. So, can you give a permission for me?
So please, you want to extend the time. So, solve every day three questions. Yes, I mean, revising the questions, okay?
Okay, sir.
Goodbye. Everyone start solving the worksheet questions. Thank you. Have a nice day. Goodbye.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Bye, sir.
Bye.